Professor Adejola and Dr. Efion Okon, and among others, Dr. Obi Ezekwesili. Not in any particular order, Dr. Obi Ezekwesili encouraged us to be more open and to come out, maybe somewhat aggressively, but accountant by nature and disciplined. Combativeness, quarrelsomeness, militant approach is not our take. But I understand the angle from where Obi is coming from. We appear to be a little bit less vocal, but I think the time has come, as our president has said, that we should be a little bit more open, more vocal, and I can assure you, our president has promised me that this time around, our decency will be more enhanced in terms of being more open and more decently engaged. Thank you very much. Having said that, I must point out that the high-level quality of this organization, of this conference, which I understand has surprised previous landmarks in all respects in terms of revenue, attendance, in spite of the constraint, is worthy of being appreciated. This is no doubt an expression of trust and confidence in the governance of IPAC. I salute you, distinguished colleagues, for this expression.
Madam President of ICANN, distinguished members of Council, past presidents, and distinguished members of ICANN. If there is any big issue that we have in the Nigerian economy today, at least from an economic and productivity point of view, I think is the high infrastructure deficit. Because when we talk about the competitiveness of an economy, I think infrastructure is at the heart of it. When we see that we are experiencing what I call deindustrialization, in other words, the situation where our industries are disappearing at a very fast rate, the situation where our factories are fast becoming event centers or worship centers or warehouses for finished goods, that is what we're experiencing now. We visit our factories or factory industrial estates in Norway, Nigeria, Kenya, and the rest of them. So infrastructure is key. The Nigerian infrastructure stock as a percentage of GDP is 25%. For the emerging economies, the average is about 70%. You can see the huge gap that we have, and you can see how competitive we are when we compare ourselves with other economies. South Africa, for instance, has 85% of GDP as its infrastructure stock. Of course, just as the chairman said, a lot is expected from the private sector, because we can see, even from the structure of our budgets, either the federal budget, the state budget, the local government budget, we have a situation where almost 80% or more of our budgets are going into recurrent expenditure. That again accounts for the kind of challenges we are facing with infrastructure. So, there's a major challenge to look at other innovative ways of funding infrastructure, which is why the private sector has been recognized as a major opportunity to fix our infrastructure challenges. But the reality is that the private sector cannot fix all infrastructure. Private sector, by its very nature, are driven by profits. So if an infrastructure component is not bankable, then you cannot expect the private sector to be there. Therefore, the government still has a major role to play in the provision of infrastructure.
To be able to get the private sector or private funds deployed in the procurement of infrastructure in Nigeria. It's important that we have infrastructure. It is clear that there's a positive relationship between our infrastructure stock and our level of GDP development and growth. So it is clear that this is what we need to do. But how do we go about doing it? I know the government and, you know, we've tried over the years to do different things, but there are issues. So I won't want to go into what Dr. Yusuf has already said, but I just want to look again at some of the problems and how we can solve some of those problems. I'll pick one. The first one being, you know, we have this issue of a project is being set up by a current government, and then a successive government comes, abandons the project, and then moves on. So we have abandoned projects all over the place, irrespective of whether private capital were involved or not. It appears as if sometimes we don't care. We just go about doing things like that.